Fast Forward. Het programma van Fonds Podiumkunsten dat Nederlands talent de mogelijkheid biedt zich internationaal te ontwikkelen. 11 deelnemers krijgen de kans met toonaangevende buitenlandse producenten samen te werken en zich te presenteren op internationale podia. In Birmingham gaan we op bezoek bij Tony Rue, bandleider en pianist van Tin Man en The Telephone. De UK is de plek waar ze samenwerken met Ed McKeon. Tin Man en The Telephone zijn geen onbekenden in de UK. Inmiddels heeft Tin Man en The Telephone een heel netwerk van mensen om zich heen die de groep helpt in hun oneindige zoektocht naar nieuwe performance-mogelijkheden binnen geïmproviseerde muziek.
So we got in contact with Fast Forward through Mark Heumann. He contacted me and he said they were basically looking for specific acts and if we could come up with an idea to work with a foreign person or organization to collaborate. We had a zakelijk leider. His name is Roland Spectay and he knew Ed McKeon from the past. They worked together. So they started calling and at some point Ed was interested. In this project we were focusing on finding new ways of interacting with the audience. And we set up the residencies over a 3-year period, like 6 residencies, which gives us a lot of time to develop things in between. And each time we work with different partners. So Ed has a big network. He has found fantastic people for us to work with.
That he's super skilled as a musician and the fact that he doesn't know what's going to happen next.
The audiences are really fantastic. The people understand the concept of humor better than most other places in the world. And another thing that I noticed during the sessions that the people that come, they often come again and they really feel like they want to participate. And I mean, also the media coverage we got so far, which Ed is doing a great job on, is, for example, I think we have been covered more than 6 or 7 times by the BBC, but also long reportages and stuff like that. So that's really, really valuable.
Yeah.
You won't normally get the chance to develop in a situation like this, where you can just create without the pressure of having to do the tour directly afterwards. Also, the idea of working with a foreign partner is great because you really build up something that, like Ed just said, and we already noticed that any of the partners we worked with before, they all seem up for meeting again, for doing more stuff, or maybe even working together in their projects.
Yeah, I think after the live broadcast on Monday night, when we had audiences from the Netherlands and Canada, as well as across the UK, interacting with the band in real time online while the band played live here in Birmingham, that way of having a globally networked live audience for a live show could be something that's really exciting to pursue. Just as producing theatre, working with a writer, developing something which is a completely new or original hybrid between the work of a writer and the work of a musical band.
Yeah, about the future, we have so many ideas, and I think the cool thing about technology is that even though we're playing old school instruments like piano, bass and drums, the technology brings in elements that are continuously changing. So if there's a new update of a computer software, or there's faster processors, or in this case, I was working on modular synthesis on the piano. The whole piano becomes like one big new instrument. That allows me to go further and further. So in that sense, the future is endless.